Papi say kick out, but me say kick with. Me like that one.
Yeah! That one just forward.
That one just forward out of the wrongs, daddy. I swear. Everybody rolling.
Yo, you want know, the thing loud, you know, catch it, you know. Sound system closing, you know. That thing you happening, you know. So if you don't get one already, go get one. You see that one, another one you have for me. Look good, though. Suit me, though. Upstairs thing. You never in the basement. That never get picked. Where someone know I go with corner league thing. That never pick. You know what I mean? So guess why I pray? Check out the thing and make the thing lead. And we say out of space, you know. Far out. You know what I mean? Sound system. Clothing. Check it. Never wreck it. I'm out. If you get a you know,
we not change how we grow. We just need little dough. TV sound system in all it is, select a hype, we're live and direct. Once again, remember, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, hit that share button. Also remember to comment below. Man, it has been an amazing 2019. Shout out reaching out to everybody that has been following the channel. You've seen what has been taking place. UK is now on a vibe. And what a vibe it is right now. You know them ones they wear. Sometimes I'm inside the studio or it's the after effect of a dance. But right now, the man them pleasantly invited me to their humble backgrounds. We're outside right now. It's summertime inside the UK, so it's a good look. And we're here talking to no other than Observer Super Powa, the UK Rumble champions for 2019. How's everything going?
Good.
Everything good?
Good.
Now, before we even start anything, can we just go along the line and everybody just, you know, voice them, the voice to the faces and for everybody to know who is who?
Yeah, Benji, you know, manager.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Okay.
I'm Twinny Ranks, the DJ. I don't say selector, because Solomon selects the songs. I don't select. Okay. Me old school, me a DJ. Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Yeah, Solomon, yeah? Selector.
Big Billy P, publicist, PR, press, you name it, media.
Media, man.
Right, yep. Promotions, etc.
Okay. So, before we start to talk about the Rumble situation, because that was crazy, I think the best thing about this interview is that that situation is kind of calmed down a little bit now, so we can kind of sit back and relax and reflect on it. But I want to pass the microphone over to Benji, and I want to try and go back to the beginning. Where was it for you where you said, you know what, you wanted to start up a sound, and the name Observer, where did that come from?
Well, I've always been around sound differently still, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. First sound, David, was lecturer.
Okay.
Lecturer, then we moved to Eternal Youth. You know what I mean? Then from Eternal Youth, now me decide to buy more of my own thing, you know what I mean? So me branch off again and start up my little thing, and Twinny was beside me, super.
And what year was that? Sorry to cut you there.
This was which one in particular?
Like when you first started to say, you know what, sound system is the
thing. I thought when me there at school, mm-hmm. I thought about 14, 15, them age there. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So ride with lecturer, brethren Keith Fuller, Dr. Michael Berryman.
So well, is that late? I don't know to guess your age. Is that late 70s, 80s?
Mid-70s. Mid-70s, I would say, yeah.
Okay, cool. And another question that I wanted to ask you again, which is going to be a little bit away from sound system. Obviously, with the whole thing that's going on right about now, post-Cold War, gangs, we see the whole knife thing and the gun thing that's happening right now. You, at that age there, growing up in Birmingham, what was it like for you as a black man growing up in the circumstances that you was? What kind of trials and tribulations did you have to go through where maybe you can see what's happening now, or where you can see where it's just
them time the really and truly it was more of a Rasta thing. You know what I mean? We have different communities of, like, obviously top hands world, bottom hands world, but you know what I mean, everybody live in love and unity and them kind of thing. There was no war, because this man come from Deso and them kind of thing there, you know. So, you know, I mean, me glad for the time when me did grow up, because there was none of this foolishness what going on nowadays, you know what I mean?
Okay, just a little insight, because
like I said, there's a lot of things going on the streets right about now, and I think sound system culture, especially for a man like yourselves, played a big part for you not going down and steering in certain different directions.
No, well, them time there, you'd have a whole heap of sound about the place, you know. You'd have sound from Top and Zerts, sound from Aston, sound from Outer Town. But them time there, there was no really warring thing going on. There was, obviously, there was competition, like, between sounds and thing, but there was no warring thing going on like that, you know what I mean?
Okay. So, like you said, you played many sound systems. Let's fast forward to the point where he says, Observer, I'm going to build a sound, and I'm going to call it Observer. I really want to know where that name came from.
Well, this was about 83, about 83, 84, around about them time there, you know. I just wanted a name that was, like, saying something, or, you know what I mean? And to me, Observer was, all right, Observer, me say, is more like myself. Me, we just go out and we just take in the vibes and just watch what go on. And we not really say too much, we just observe what go on. So to me, that was the ideal name for the sound then, Observer.
And then from there, was it, is it right that Twinny came on?
Yeah,
from
Twinny
there?
And him brother, Fathead. Because them time, the sound was more of a DJ vibes. You know what I mean? Because we'd have enough little DJ, Danny Banton, Mellow Man, Little D. You know what I mean? It was more of a Super D. You know what I mean? Them time, it was more, you know what I mean, turnover and play the B-side and the man must jump on it and, you know what I mean?
Okay, so Twinny, big up yourself, ask you a few questions. But that time there when you made that link with Observer, what made you decide to say, you know what, Observer's going to be the sound I'm going to link with? Because obviously there was bare sounds going on in Birmingham at that time there. What made you decide to just link up with Observer?
Well, I wouldn't say I was part of the song, but I used to help move the boxes for like Lecturer and Eternal Youth. And even before that, an old-time Answorth song named Bismarck.
Okay.
You know, the original song, you know. But even before that, that song named Studio One, a man named Phil.
Okay.
You know what I mean? That's, you have a song named Cipher Sound, you know, that was their dad. You know what I mean? Phil used to play for my daddy on the cellar and, you know, couple dance when my dad used to keep back in the day. So it's coming from them times. And I always used to like holding a microphone in my hand. And from a little bit older, I always wanted to be around a sound playing a pivotal role. So when Benji came with the idea, you know, we jumped to it straight away, you know, and started writing lyrics, because at the time was listening to Be A Yard Cassette, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And Stereograph, Kilimanjaro, you know, ESC's International, all these early songs we used to listen to, you know what I mean? Jell of Music. And I was inspired, very much inspired, you know, me, my twin brother, my elder brother, Jaro, you know what I mean? R.I.P., you know. And we just loved it. And so I used to listen to these tapes, listen to the lyrics, copy the lyrics. Then later on, I started to write my own lyrics. And to go down Benji Yard and practice and make cassettes and put the cassette out on the road. When the cassettes went out on the road, people never really believed it was an English sound. People believe it's a yard sound. You know, because we had that yard vibes. We never go with that Saxon vibe. We never have that vibe in a way. It's strictly yard, it's yard vibes, you know? So, it's coming from there really, you know, and it just went on from there and,
And between the two of you, obviously, you've linked now with Twinny. You're now kind of like taking the thing serious, because now you're not listening to the cassettes. Them now you're like writing your own lyrics. At that point there between the two of you, where did you expect or where did you want Observer to reach? Was there a main goal, or was it just still a thing where we just enjoy life and enjoy music?
Well, at the time, you know, no. If I be honest with you, you know, I always wanted to be the best. You know, even when we used to write lyrics and that kind of things, I wanted to be writing the best lyrics. If I heard a DJ and it sounded good, I wanted to be better. You know what I mean? So that would encourage me to go home and write even better material. You know, I mean, I write lyrics from like 1983, 84. I've been writing lyrics from them times. I used to write a lot of lyrics. You know, I used to be at work all day, coming home with like 4, 5, 6 different lyrics daily. You know? And that's where it's coming from.
Okay, so we...
That's where it's coming from.
We fast forward... Right the way. So that was, we're talking 80s that time there, yeah?
Yes.
At that time there, you come out with Observer. How long did it take for Observer to reach a platform where people recognize as a good sound system? Sometimes it takes...
We're within a year. Within 1 year. Yeah. You know, we're playing with Radigan, Barry G. You know, at the time, the big sounds only was Master Blaster, Stereo Classic, they were the big sounds in the area. Master Blaster, that's with Corporal and Zuki, as you know, from Love Injection. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we used to play with these sounds and, you know, we was the top sound. Mm-hmm. We were the bad man sound, you know, at the time. Not being boastful, but we it's something that we used to work at. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? The first bad DJ made it here. We go out and say, shit, me never even know a DJ like them. Yeah, the day about it was Corporal Billy.
Okay.
One dance, the first time we play with them at Oaklands.
Mm-hmm. You know when you got dub plays, the ringtone speak.
Yeah, you know, yeah. And before I go any further, I must just say that Gunzi, one of the crew members, is not here at the moment. He's working late, so I don't know if he's will come in later or whatever. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah. Is that what was I saying anyway? What was I talking about?
It was Billy.
Billy. Bad DJ. Because obviously, Barna Jumea can't come with that yard vibes, the vibes that we used to like. Mm-hmm. It was the first bad DJ me here, and I knew I had to go, man. I even be better. So I went home and started writing more material, practicing more, and I got better at my craft. You know what I mean? So to me get recognized, and you know what I mean? People started, like even Valerie, you know what I mean? Coming to book me up for certain dances and kind of something, they're paying good wages.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Valerie's always pay good. Lady V, we are talking of, pay good wages. And, it came from there, really. You know, we played at all the big dances then. From a year, 2 years in the business, we played at the biggest dances.
Yeah.
Anytime when Saxon come to Birmingham, after when we launched, you know what I mean? It was we was always in that dance. Sometimes we and with Stereo Classic, sometimes we with Master Blaster. Because Saxon was, they were massive at the time. Everybody knew that, you know what I mean? And we used to hold we won anyway, you know?
Did you, between you and Benji, did you find it easy at that time? Because for as long as I know Sound System and what's going on in and around Birmingham, it always has been, Observer's name has always been called. So during that time, when you was playing with some of the best and doing your thing, how competitive was it? Was it something that you kind of like thought, you know what, we're very comfortable with what we're doing right now and constantly be consistent and relevant? Or was it like a lot of work ethic, a lot of pressure on you to maintain that name, to be Observer, to like literally stand firm right now in modern times?
No, well, really and truly, it wasn't a lot of pressure as such, because we born and grew up in Zurich, you know what I mean? We have the people them on our side, you know what I mean? Promoter, everybody we grow with. Mm-hmm. So, you know what I mean? The promoter them put up on a dance or anything, it wasn't nothing still.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? My brethren, Big T, Massive, Josie, them Monday, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. The Monday we just put up on dance.
Mm-hmm. And was there any sounds during that time, especially the 90s? I know Observer from like about 93.
Mm-hmm.
When I started to play sound, he was like, yo, that's all the Observer. You know? I took him in a few times and he was like, yo, okay. And it was the time when I was playing Young Sound, and it was the Young Rebel, Young Love Injections and this, that and the other. And it was, yo, Yacht, if you want, get big, you know, if you listen to them sound, they're like Observer and this, that and the other. So the question I'm asking is throughout the 90s, how did you see things change and how did you adapt? And who in the 90s did you see in Birmingham really dominating the situation apart from yourselves?
Okay, with me, myself, I kind of took my foot off the brakes late 80s, about 89, yeah? And that was the time when Major Popular and Bionic Steel came in on the sound and more or less took over and did brilliantly well. You know, they've done really, really well. You know, but Bionic Steel was the top selector. You know what I mean? A lot of people copy this style.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Copy this format, you know, in playlists. You know what I mean? Literally copy this from the first tune right down to the last tune. People's copying Bionic Steel. And that was like going right through the 90s, you know. It was Bionic Steel and Major Popular really, really, really doing well. But Super D was still there all the time. Guns has always been there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Guns is the backbone, you know?
Mm-hmm.
He's always been there. But at that time, I was more like a family man. I took a back seat.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm looking after the family, bringing the kids to school and all, bringing them more, cooking them dinner. I didn't have time for sound at that time. And but Benji can tell you more about the 90s, what was going on in the 90s.
Yeah, that,
you know?
that 90s era, especially in Birmingham, was, for me, was a big deal. As somebody coming out and as a youth, going to, I think it was Oaklands was one of the places I was going. I was going to Summerfield.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was mad tense. Like, I'm coming from Wolverhampton, you know, I'm with teeth in the car to just drive over to hear the big sound and play. And when you was in the dance, and things, it was just like, yo, this ain't a game right about now.
Mm.
So like I was saying, like, how competitive was it for you back in well, that 90s era?
Well, the 90s era, no, we mostly was doing like, the blues dance and the parties and them thing there. I mean, Love Injection, it come about by them time there, and them was really running the place. I'm not gonna lie. You know what I mean? Them was on all the big dance, them and them the time that the man start cut dub and you know the rest. You know, so I would say the '90s really kinda belong to Love Injection. Because them, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Them see through the years and thing, you know what I mean?
And during that time, we can just at that time when you was playing Observer, was it a Dubplate thing at the beginning, or when did the Dubplate situation kind of creep in?
No, well, funny enough, you know, me had Dubplate from the start, you know, because from me first go to Jamaica, like 1984 and thing, me cut couple dub, couple Anthony Red Rose, Half Pint, Junior Reed, and you know what I mean?
Anthony Red Rose.
Anthony Red Rose, and yeah, me go down to Jammies, you know what I mean? Walk down to Jammies on a Waterhouse. Yeah, I'm gonna cut two dub and thing live on the dub plate, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Style.
Yeah, man, of course. You know what I mean? So, from them time, me always did love the dub thing, but me never really live on it. Come and find, say, well, boy, the people, them, where we're there in England right now, is more commercial stuff than one year. You know, I'm the 45, the soul, the lovers rock and thing. So, me never really lived on the dub road, but any opportunity, I'm gonna cut a little one dub. We cut a little one dub and put down, you know, like a one dub and put down, you know what I mean?
Yeah. So, it's TV Sound System, we're here. Observer is inside the building. We've just touched a little bit on the 80s, 90s. The millennium kicks in. Observer's name still calling, still on flyers, still playing. And around about that time there, we started to have the UK Cup Clash, when it takes all, and all those situations. When you was either went to those events or heard about them, was that something where you thought, man can go in there, you know, and lock that down easy?
I never really see myself in there, because like me say, at the time, I was more looking on, you know what I mean, the commercial stuff and, you know, just playing out for the sake of playing out still. I wasn't really looking at it to say, well, boy, I'd like to be in here. But like me say, I was cutting like a one dub here, like a one dub there. And as you know, after a couple of years, them thing there pile up, you know what I mean?
and throughout the 2000 era then, and you was going to those dances and seeing what was going on,
yeah,
who was impressing you in that era there, like for the 2000s? I mean, you could see coming through and say, you know what, I was in there in the 80s, the 90s,
yeah,
and I mean, I see some new,
well, like me say through. Again, we have to get to Love Injection, because the man that was consistent over the years, you know what I mean, with sound as well as music. Anything new come out, then man would always change to the latest sound equipment or whatever. You know what I mean? I mean, even German Nuclear, one of the time, me look at me, I said, boy, yeah, man, sound from Wolverhampton are going good. You know what I mean? Because I'm taking me, in, was it UK Cup Clash one of the time?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Don't London, London, where did you go?
London.
Yeah, man.
Chucks.
Yes, man. Yeah, and yeah. Me say, yeah, man, that's like a sound are going good, though.
Good sound.
Yeah man. For real. Can't take it away.
Let's fast forward again, because there's so many questions to ask. And you know, big shout out, reach out to everybody who's just logging in right about now. I'm gonna go back to 20. Big shout out, reach out to the rest of the members.
You know, Selector Ipe.
We soon make man shoot, you know.
Selector Ipe. No one's ever gotten that much out of Benji. No interviewer has ever gotten so many words out of the manager.
But I wanted to come back to you, which you made a good point. Which I want to kind of go into a little bit. When you said you took a break, and you was like, you know what, it's family first and work and whatever else. How much of your heart was still in Sound System?
I was still observing, man. I used to still go out to help them move the boxes and come back and see me going out and just never feel the vibes to go back out again. I've always been there or thereabout. Yeah. You know what I mean? I've never really left. A lot of the times when Bionic and Major was running, I'd be there. You know what I mean? I'd be there in the dance, you know. Sometimes just take the mic just to keep the vibes, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
To make sure some still have it, you know? Yeah.
And what made the transition to make you come back and like really kind of help spear front what's going on right now?
Because Major and Bionic went off and started to do their own thing. And nothing really much wasn't happening for the sound. But me notice, secretly Benja get little dub plate here and there. So, you know what I mean? Me that do my little juggling too at the time. I'm saying, you know something, Benji? Yeah, Benji, try get this dub here, so. Get that dub, you know what I mean? Get that money, give Benji, get that dub. And at first, just me and Benji. Just me and Benji alone, you know, the dub thing. And a lot of the other guys didn't really agree with it. They wanted the party thing. And yeah. I wasn't really a party, man. I've always been on the rough side of things, you know? Yeah, the DJ side of things. I was on the rough DJ, you know?
cultural DJ. That's what I preferred. And then so when Benji started getting the dub them, that was my what I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. And even going to the clashes them in London and all them thing there, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Going to the
just
clash them.
Everything else.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I used to sit down and watch Mighty Cone all these songs mm-hmm. on stage. I think to myself, we could have do that, you know.
And
yeah,
and
man, we can do that, man.
It must be a big deal because it's like he says in the earlys, and I hate to use the word humble, you know. Mm-hmm. When you got mad confidence and you know you're talented,
mm-hmm.
you must have just thought, man, I can do this.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Definitely.
So when that manifested to where it is now,
mm-hmm.
what's your plans right now on Observer? Because I'm going to kind of fast forward it to you now. As one, like I said, one of the people who are spearfronting the thing, it's coming up to 2020 right now. Times are changing, things are moving, selectors are playing faster, this, that, and the other. How are you gonna do it so well in the Rumble, but still be able to be consistent on what's going on right now? How much do you know about what's going on right now?
Salomon, okay. We have the youths, them, you know what I mean? Around, we have Sanction, you know what I mean? We have Tyson, these are the young ones in the crew
yeah.
who know what's going on, but we still know what's going on as well. And you talk about things going faster, people selecting faster. I've realized lately that, you know what I mean? Yeah, people have to slow back down again, because if you realize, oh, we played in the clash, no, we're not allowed, you know, yeah. we make tune run, we make tune breathe, we play tune for y'all, 2 minutes, make tune run. Yeah, and you know something, have you watched Global Clash?
No, I haven't.
You don't watch it yet?
No.
Will Warrior win? And just look at the kind of tunes what Warrior play mm-hmm. and win. You can't think to yourself and wonder if things are changing again.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
They say that in sound system. Yeah. They say that yeah. what goes around comes around.
That's what I say.
And I always, and this is why I rate
people
Observer.
All right. People want to hear music. Like, that's why you had so many women down at the clash. So many mm-hmm. big people at the clash. Because them know so Observer was involved. And them know how we do a thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? We please the ladies. We please the big man them. You know what I mean? All the article Rasta man them. Them know see how Observer fit them sound. Because Observer go play the tune them with them 1 year.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know?
Definitely.
You know what
definitely.
I mean?
Yeah. yeah.
You know what I mean?
There's a lot of things that I rate about Observer. And,
you know?
And the UK Rumble was a big deal for me. Because I said to myself, I told everybody already I bet £200 on Observer.
Mm-hmm.
That was out of a mad conversation as well. It was just that somebody was just trying to just talk to me about sound system culture, and I was trying to say something. And in front of a whole heap of people, he was like, I said, I bet you £200 Observer win.
Mm.
Everything get quiet. All right then. So we just poured out the money and thing, and then boom. But for me, the minute I walked inside the place, I was like, oh man, this is a vibes, man. The energy is crazy. And I rate and respect every single sound.
Yeah.
But I think for me, the minute that you came on, I just says, I feel mad comfortable with what you're doing.
Mm.
The way how you play music is what is missing in the clash right now.
Mm.
Songs are playing. And key songs are playing as well. Big songs are playing. Mm-hmm. Songs that people know that you don't have to cut for like 30 seconds. It can run. And I think you proved that as well on War Report.
Mm.
Your show on War Report was exceptionally well presented because songs was playing.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just like, Unaman is just on, it's not even first gear. So enough respect to the way how you're going to be playing music now.
Again, following like, I was watching all the comments on the War Report, and there was a number of sounds from all over the world. And I don't think I've seen anybody saying, oh, no, they're too mm-hmm. slow or whatever. Everybody was saying, this is how we used to remember it. This is how we know it. This is what we love now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, this 30, you know, pull a tune on for 10 seconds, whip it off.
Mm-hmm.
It's, you know, maybe that can work for certain sounds, but mm-hmm. that's not the road that Observer's ever taken or will take.
And as somebody that kind of like deals with the social media side of things, the presentation, how you want to see people perceive Observer as, is that something that you think Observer should have to adjust with if they're playing that particular sound, or should Observer just be a sound and say, yo, so we play it and we're now going on that layer?
That's exactly it, Hype. Observer's not going to follow no sound or go down the road of any sound, because what they're doing is a unique thing in which every yeah, people realize again, and you use that term a few times, Twinny, about allowing a sound, allowing the tune to breathe. People want to hear the tunes. Mm-hmm. People want to hear how the tune's been put together, how it's constructed, everything. So when you play an intro and you whip it off, you're not hearing anything.
Yeah.
And again, I'm seeing, following social media hype, a lot of people are saying, yes, this is what we want. This is how we know Clash to be.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The third, the 10, 15, 20 second pull off, maybe that's the way it's going. Mm-hmm. But I can assure you, you won't see Observer going down that road. And again, it was proved by that trophy there. That is what the people wanted to hear.
Yeah.
Because remember, a lot, again, there was a lot of people say, oh, Observer, the pensioner sounds. Hang on, which one of us are pensioners? Come on. You know, which one of the, but, you know, to inc- you know, these other times, they would say, oh, the old boy sounds. You should have seen some of the comments on the UK Rumble WhatsApp page that we had. But, you know, every, at the end of the day, you know, it's just about being original, keep staying as close to what we all know sound system is and what we all, you know, grew up in, into.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Definitely, man. Trust me.
Yeah.
We're going to hand over to the mic to the shooter.
Solomon, shoot!
To me... I saw you at the birthday party, fam. Remember, was at the birthday party?
Yeah.
We was at the birthday party.
Yeah.
Solomon was doing his thing. Yeah. I was doing my little slush thing.
Yep.
And to be honest, it was like the first time we kind of met.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And we was talking. And then I was like, yeah, man, you're playing some songs. And that. You know when something doesn't click? And then he says, yeah, man, I'm just getting myself ready for Rumble, you know. This was about, what? About
2 weeks before Rumble?
Yeah, about 2 weeks before Rumble.
Yeah.
And he was like, yeah, I'm just gearing up myself ready for Rumble and getting my songs ready. And I said, wait, but I'm not a selector for Observer. And the way how you come across so humble, you didn't come off with no, yo, you know what I mean? I'm Solomon, everything, I got dead, you know, I kill everything. The way how you just kind of laid back on the thing, and then the way how you play music now, it's good times for you right now.
Excellent times right now.
I mean, being the young part of the camp right about now, being around so many elders, what's the most important thing that you're learning right about now?
Just what you said there, you know, how to be humble, how to be chilled, relaxed. I'm learning music still, you get me? I ain't gonna lie, like I know music, I don't know music. I'm learning music, so every day that I kind of come through is like another step on the journey, yeah? To where probably at this minute I don't even know where I want to reach, you know what I mean? But it's still just a learning curve. Every time we have a conversation and talk about something different or talk about a tune or artists, certain artists I don't even know.
Yeah.
You have to remember, you know, Observer come what these are formed at 83.
Yeah.
I was born 86, you know what I'm saying? These man give me dubs, yeah, that from the year I was born. And I'm looking at it thinking, boy, I've never heard of this artist in my life. So I have to listen him, study him, understand the dub, get some legal history in my head as well. So it's been constant learning, you know what I mean? It's a hard journey, I'm not going to lie. It's not easy, but it's been a hard journey. But it's good.
It's crazy because the age that you are now, which is kind of, you're young. You're the youngest one out there right about now. And when it comes to the young thing on terms of sound system thing, it's like a social media thing.
Yeah.
Everybody's making up noise. Everybody's doing this. Everybody had played this and them do this and them do that. When technically, you're kind of like one of the big selectors that out there right now where technically if we sit down, man can't really talk to Solomon, you know.
Yeah.
He's in a position in a camp where he can't really ramp with. How do you keep that level head not to go on social media like some man and be like, yo, you know who you're ramping with? And really kind of like use that social media level to kind of push Observer rather than what you're doing now, which is like literally I don't see you on social media at all.
I'm there I comment and I post what I need to post and so on. As I said, I'm a person like this, and this is what I'm seeing on social media. Someone, they hear something, kind of jump on and type and put it down straight away. You get me? And then before you know it, by the time the comments kick in, they were wrong or they got an argument about something and they didn't do their research. I'm taking learning from social media as well. There's certain people I follow that, you know what I mean? They're educating me on this, on the whole sound system culture as well. Mm. But I'm not hype with it. I ain't gonna get on there and go, oh yeah, yeah. I'm Solomon and me this and me that and mm-hmm. me. Nah, I'm still humble. I'm still just me. I love music. That's what I love. You know what I'm saying?
Why sound system culture? Considering what's going on now, grime, hip hop, drum and bass. You know, yeah. You could ease, like, to the way how talented you are, man could just run a solo thing and do one of them, you know, them little laptop DJ kind of vibes. Why embrace sound system culture so much at such an age where you're at now?
You know what it is? I'll be honest, I fell into this, you know. I fell into it, in a sense. And it was random because I think I played somewhere. I weren't even meant to play there. I've gone to a christening, I think it was, and Benji's playing. Uh-huh. And I think the girl come up to me and said, can you play for me? I'm like, why? You know what I mean? I'm a man like this. I've always got my laptop on me. No matter where I go, it's on me just in case. You know what I mean? And she said, can I play? And I said, all right, then I'll play. So we went up there and we played a couple tunes. And I remember Benji just come and said, yo, I like the vibes and we should link up. And before that, he linked my cousin, in a sense. He was having some correspondence with Sanction. Mm-hmm. And then a couple months later, we booked up at the same venue. No, not the same venue, but a different venue.
Okay.
And he come back and he said, yo, listen, we link up. And I said, yo, man, all right. And that's when we kind of exchanged the numbers and so on. Mm. And then it's like I come around. I remember it was Pavilions, Perry Bar, and invited me down, and it was just an outside thing, and I played some music and whatever. And I like the vibe. I like the way everybody kind of doubted me nice, in a sense, because I was new to it, in a sense. I've been playing music and I had like little residences and so on, but I was new to this kind of big sound system thing. Mm-hmm. And then one day they just said, yo, is the Dubplate folder? And I said, what? You know what I mean? So you see what I'm, you have to understand this, you know. I used to go through them and not know half of the dubs. As I said, there's a deep box there, you know. So I didn't understand half of the tunes. I'm a man like this. At that time, I was just looking for the big artist, the Mavado, like, and the Killer, yeah, and the, you know what I mean? I'm looking for them. And them things are on repeat, but I'm in my yard with my kids, so I can't even play them tunes, you know. So it was like, it was kind of it was weird. So it was just a learning curve, and then we started taking a couple things and kept taking a couple, not even clashes, but I think it was a One Love, the first thing that I went into, innit? Hit me. And it was like, you're going to be on the main stage and you're doing something, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it was like, even doing that, I didn't know what I was walking into, you know what I'm saying? You have to remember, you know, I've done 2 One Loves, 3 War Reports, 145 Shop Lock, and a UK Rumble. That's the only times I've played Dubplates in a real, you know what I mean? So it was like, at that time, I was just kind of, I was worried for it, but I knew it was something I liked, because I used to listen to sound things. I used to listen to all the sound tapes and listen to them, but I never seen myself there.
Yeah.
Never. Mm-hmm. So when I started to get little dubs, and I remember the first dub that said my name, what? Listen. What?
Sweet, you know.
Listen.
That's it, man. Listen. I'm telling you.
You see that dub plate there? I'm telling you. Them thing never just getting, yo, press up. All my kids are like, daddy, you just said your name. And I'm saying, yeah. So that was it for me. From when you get that, and then I got 2 little jingles coming through, and 2 little, I'm saying, yo, this is me. And that was it. There's no turning back from that point.
And now you've reached such a high scale. Like, the world know about you now, fam. Like, when it comes to UK and sound system culture, the world know about you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Being on that platform now, who are the sounds are you looking at? Because now you've got to probably even study other sounds a lot more. Is there any sound that you really like, even when it was back in the day, or somebody that's current right now, that you think, yeah, that sound there... Eventually, I feel like the way how Observer is going,
you
might have to buck up with them. Is there a particular sound that you would like to clash, or a sound that you're watching and feeling like you get a vibes from?
Not as such someone that I'd say I would like to clash, you get me? Because I'm being honest, I've got no fear. Mm-hmm. I've got no fear at this present moment. If someone does the right business and so on, I will clash anybody, win or lose. That's how it's going. Mm-hmm. But there's been sounds growing up, I used to watch certain sounds, and I grew up around sort of like, living in the area was like One Ras and Tyrone, and so I'd see them, man, all the time, you get what I mean? And then listen to them do their thing, and Immortal was my sound, in a sense. Immortal was my sound. I rate them to, I still do you get what I mean?
Yeah.
But it was like, it was kind of, I never seen it like, oh yeah, I want to get to that height, I want to get to them, and I still don't see it, I want to get to them. To me, the Rumble was going against some big sounds. Mm-hmm. You understand? So when you're looking at Empire and Classic and more than their sounds that I've heard of all the way through, I know Jermaine, so it was like, all right, then I'm on a stage where it's me against him. What? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? What?
What did you feel at that time? Because I remember that, like, this is why I rate Observer so much, because it reminded me as when I was playing sound. I was surrounded by bare big man, and I was like the young guy to play the sound and put the sound and present it in such a way, and had to represent it in such a way where it had to come across very, very well.
Yeah.
How stressful was that for you, the build up for UK Rumble, and realizing where it was going to go?
It was very stressful. Mm-hmm. And now that we've come at the end of it, it's still, now I look at it, the stress was worth it, because it's a learning curve as well. Mm-hmm. Even though we got the trophy, I still learned a lot. Mm-hmm. And you're seeing where your faults were, you're seeing how you had to tweak things and change things. Mm-hmm. You had to learn things. But then every kind of planning and prep that you're going through into when you prepare, mm-hmm. when you step on that stage and look at all them people right there, and you hear all them horns blow, and everyone goes, yo, that's a different kind of situation.
Is that the pinnacle of your career so far?
Yeah. Rumble's done it for me. Definitely.
Pinnacle for that.
Yeah.
For the whole sound, on the whole, you think it's all...
Because, you know,
the big stage that the sound has gone on, and to achieve the victory, it's got to be the biggest thing so far.
I was going to say, because I know that you've all been through different stages, and I know, Benji, there may be a different kind of dance, because I know that this to you, I think, is just another stepping stone for Observer. But as a big man who's built this sound from scratch, is there any like key dances where you thought, the remembering dances where really something took place and it will always embed in your head away from UK Rumble?
Yeah, I would say the Stereograph at Tower Ballroom.
Mm-hmm.
Tower Ballroom with Stereograph. He had all the entertainers, Coca T, Yellow Man. Who else did it?
Coca T.
General Trees, Twitch, all the man that did the Uri.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, man, that my era, that, you know, because them man that me grew up, I listened to.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
That was one of the key.
Yeah, man, definitely.
And 1986,
mm-hmm.
we played, I got Jamaica. For the first time, 1986, when Benji sent me down with some plates, he sent me down some tape reels. You know, if me carry go at jammies, that's one of the big experience in life, when we go at jammies and jammies open the door. We were going there, so jammies himself was on the mixing down with something there. It's a pity, so we never have phone and them things in them days. I could have filmed all this. Crazy. You know what I mean? I went in the booth and advice couple tune. I've got them on Dubplate still, you know what I mean? I can't remember what tune them was still, but that was a pivotal moment. The day we land back at England, 31st of July, I think it was, 1986, June, right? We played with Saxon up at Oaklands. When we go up Oaklands, ram! That time we come, we roll up a new Dubplate there, man. We have some new lyrics, we build up a Jamaica, and, you know what I mean? We ready to flash them in the dance, and that was a big dance. That was a wonderful dance. And the funny thing about it, if you go on the social media, on the net, it have like Saxon Observer. But and it's just a Saxon side. It's my David. But that's his fault, really. That's Patrick's fault now, because Patrick is the media man, and he's supposed to have all these. There's a lot of material that we've got to put up on social media. But that was a pivotal dance, you know, man. Even the dance up at Plaza, although it never big enough, Benji, the we win the trophy. Up at Plaza.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That was a big sound.
That was a big dance.
There's a big dance too, you know? And we've played at some, you know what I mean, some real big dance. Even the Radigan, Barry G, you know what I mean, Master Blaster, Stereo Classic, Barry G never turned up, but that was a big dance. Another big dance we play at Henry's Nightclub with Radigan. This is in the early, mid-80s. That time Radigan, I put the tune up on the deck and I have the mic, and I have DJ up on for Radigan on the B-side, I'm tuned them. That was a big time for me, you know, because Radigan, no matter what anybody wants to say about Radigan, throughout the decades, it's been massive. No care what guy wants to say about him, and he's good what he does.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? No matter what a man wants to say about Radigan, he is very good at what he does, and he presents himself in a wonderful way. I like going out and seeing Radigan, and we shake, and he always remembers me, because he's the only one who asks him for one tune where he might have a Janolt. What's the tune in the name of it? The Clock. Janolt, okay, where him have, and I always ask him to play it, and him always tell me he's the only man who asked him to play it. I love the tune so much I had to vice it myself too. The all clock, right, you know. Yeah, man.
I'm gonna
pivotal moments in our career, man. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. We had a wonderful time. I would love Salaman too. Like, big and serious, you know. It's Salaman. I don't see my little youth, you know. A married man, you know, and take care of him wife and him kids. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And him wife has stolen to be a liar. Mm-hmm. Yo, I tell you, say, proud of him.
So many things going on.
Yeah, man.
So
proud of Salaman. Yeah, yeah, man.
Benji, I'm going to ask you one particular question, and then we're going to wrap it up. But I'm going to wrap it up with some fun. Okay, we're going to ask some different questions.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Benji, I always try and work out with the sound man them who own sound systems. Mm. What keeps that passion and drive going? Because at the end of the day, you always see the manager who barely does nothing.
Now
you always see, I mean, in terms of like, I mean, like at the forefront, not MC.
Now
I'm
do everything, man. Me lift back, okay. me lift box. me play a funeral and all these things.
But what? Okay, then. So what just makes a good manager then? Because there's a lot of investment, there's a lot of time, there's a lot of effort. But what keeps that vibe in you to keep going and supporting your team that's around you?
Well, number one, it have to be something you love doing, mm-hmm. which I love doing it. You know what I mean? I just like to be there watching the people, them. You know what I mean? Music I play and everybody happy listening to the song. Obviously, the song have to be sounding crisp. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Yeah, man, I just love it. Mm-hmm. I just love it. From my youth, I love it till now. You know what I mean?
And it's been such a... such a positive progress.
Yeah, if I can just say, talking about Benji as well, mm-hmm. to be honest with you, yeah, if it wasn't for Benji, I don't feel so the song would have been going on from mm-hmm. this or to now. It'd have come off the road at some stage. Because even when me come off the road, you know, for a while, Benji still have the song around. Mm-hmm. When Major and Barney come off the road, through Benji, the song still around.
Always kept you going.
All right, well, the song around from them time, though. I mean, at one stage, the song was, it was just hiring out. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Anybody want a good sound, whatever. You know what I mean? We just hire up the sound. So it's still in our work, although we wasn't really working as observer like that. But the sound's always been working. So, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. The sound, our equipment always a buy. And, you know what I mean? Keep up with what I go on till now.
Okay. Speaking of buying, we're going to wrap it up very soon. But let's have... this is a true or false question. Because this one went round. A few people were saying, boy... this is the question, okay? Did Observer spend £20,000 for UK Rumble?
No, sir.
Now, anybody who's watching this knows that I got at least 4 or 5 conversations where it came up. So nobody can't say I'm just throwing this out there. They said, yo, you know, sir, £20,000 them spend, you know, I just for playing the dance, you know? Yo, you know, say Observer spent £20,000 for playing the dance.
You mad, man.
So, man. It's just a question. It's like for you to answer.
If he spent £20,000, he would not know about it. Nah, man. We have links, you know, hype. Mm-hmm. A long time we know this.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Phone call, email, whatever. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? We don't really have to go down the road. Man, if we go to Jamaica, go every studio, go bleach pan artists all night mm-hmm. and them thing there. You know what I mean?
How important is it to get the best dub plates possible right now?
Well, number one, you have to have a reliable source the other end. Because you don't know, man, we take away your money or give you splice or whatever. Mm. You know what I mean? But if you have a good link the other end and, you know, people you can trust or whatever, mm-hmm. yeah, man, we can get anything. We can get any artist. Yeah. Even if we have to dig them out of them house and record them on laptop, whatever. You know what I mean? We can get anybody.
Well, so there you have it, massive. I said I was going to ask the question, you know. So there you go. They spent like 500 there or something like that.
So for those of you out there who are saying Observers, which hype they can ask. Listen, as you can see, we're very open.
I think it was when. Twinny, was it that you that came out of the bank?
The bank, yeah.
Oh, you know, the bank, yes, that's where it started to come from.
That's where it came. I'm not saying that he said it, but it just kind of surfaced, and I thought, raw, really?
Yeah.
And I was like, it's a mad thing.
Yeah. What I would say is that all of those who are wondering if Observer spent £20,000, we can say, no, we didn't. Mm-hmm. What I will say, though, as Benji eloquently put earlier, is that we've got the links And from you got a good link, you don't need to spend 20 grand. It's also about being creative with your dubs.
Yeah.
And have that creative mind. So you can build a dub where it might sound expensive, but you know?
Yeah.
I just wanted to say, just quick, there's dubs in the box right now that I know have come since I've been on the sound. I've never played yet.
Yeah.
Outer road, yeah? So it's not that we had to rush and go and buy, because there's still things that are sitting down, but it's the right time for that dub. You understand what I'm saying? When you get the right time for it, the dub will play. And because no one's ever heard it, they're going to assume it's new. It don't mean it's new, it means it's just there. Yeah. You understand? It might not have Solomon name it, but you get me? It's still there and it ain't gonna the road. That's it, you get me? Royal Report showed it.
We're gonna fast forward. UK run, but congratulations once again. It's world clash time.
Yeah.
Who's going? And the reason why I'm asking who's going is because I hope to see all of you.
Everyone's there. Everyone's there.
Yes.
Listen.
Do you know how much it's important to me? Because I watched the... I was at the Clash, UK Rumble.
I've
been following Observer. I filmed, edited, I cut and pasted, this, that, and the other. And I could watch you together as a team, how much it meant to you guys. And I thought, man, if they just sent two men over there to go around, I hope to see the whole team and experience that situation.
Can I just say, what we're actually doing at the moment is waiting on the date. Because there are people who are blowing off my phone wanting the date. Because one thing I'll tell you, Hi, we will be going with fans. We will be going with fans. We're not going to be doing what other sounds have done in the past. You've gone to Canada or you've gone to the US and you ain't got no fans. One of the things we work on is making sure our fans are well looked after. They will be there in Canada. Trust me.
Wow.
I've just sent a big request talking about Canada to Ricky Turbo.
Yeah.
He always sends good messages when we're on the radio or playing tunes. He always say Ricky Turbo from King Turbo Sound in Canada. You know what I mean? He was one of our fans. And I know that he will be there cheering us on. Big up yourself, Ricky Turbo. You know? I remember we're going back to tunes, you know. It's not just now Benji had the tune, you know. Benji's been doing tunes from early 80s when Benji used to get tune pan CD and pan vinyl and all the people have to come to Benji for these tunes. It's not just something we just started nowadays. A long time Benji have certain links with certain artists. All the sound of the motor road, I figure respect to Benji because Benji put certain tunes in them box. And I'm not going to tell you these things, but a lot of sound man come to Benji to try to get this and get that or whatever because they know a few links them, you're not necessarily going to get done. You know what I mean? All right.
Well, what can I say? We're going to wrap it up there. It's been a moment. It's a movie we're watching right about now. We're watching the journey of no other than Observer Sound.
Who
have constantly have been in this. And this is the reason why I wanted to come out. And thank you for bringing me in such a pleasant surroundings as well. So people can see the way how Soundman do their thing as a team and come together. I really believe that we're going to see something big right now. So for the people them across the world who only just seen Observer from UK Rumble and say, we also hold our sound there. Or then just come with a bag of fans and don't know anything. I hope this gave you a little bit of insight of what's going on. I personally am a fan and I will always continue to follow your journey. So we're going to wrap it up like that. Is there anybody quickly that you need to go and big up?
Just big up the whole crew. Gunzi, Fathead, Super D, the whole massive, you know what I mean? All the whole time crew. You know what I mean? Percival, all the man there, you know what I mean? We're help. Put Observer or Observer then now. Bionic, Major Popular, you know. The whole entourage, you know what I mean? You can't think of any more names, Benji, off your head so quickly. You know what I mean? Meloman, Danny Bantan, Ringo Culture. It was another wicked DJ just like Major Popular, but it just say, you know what I mean? I look for Heavy D, originally called Little Deep on the sound, Demos. Yeah, and
for those who have always been with the sound, but
have passed on until, you know, to other things. Willie Minot, you know what I mean? Sifa R.I.P. Gerald, you know what I mean? Yeah, that Jamaica now, ain't it? Gerald living in Jamaica now. Jaro, that's my brother. This is my brother, by the way. This is another one of my brothers. And my brother Jaro, we call him Jaro because he used to love Jaro Cassette, love Kilimanjaro sound like nothing. So his name was Jaro, but he passed away in 2011. Okay. You know what I mean? And he would have been so happy to see, you know what I mean, the achievement we are going with now. You know what I mean? And we have more to come to because we're going for the World Cup and we're going to win it too. We're now going for Rampy Salaman. Yeah? Shoot!
And don't worry,
you will get that first interview.
I need to get that.
Trust
you know
me.
I get the first interviews, man. Trust. I don't care who says I got the first interview. You never got the first interview.
That's one more thing. Big up all the fans, yeah? Big up all of the fans. Everybody that rode out, everyone in Team Observer, everybody that listened to us or comes out to support us. You know what I mean? Big up everybody. Big up yourself.
Thank you, Lady V, for giving us the opportunity to bring this trophy back to Birmingham.
Yeah.
Handsworth.
Yeah, man.
We're not in Handsworth, no.
I'm not really sure where we are right about now, but listen, we're going to wrap it up like this. We're going to wrap it up like this. I'm not actually sure where I'm at right now.
Right,
but let me tell you something. It's a nice settings. I got a view.
Yeah.
And like Benji says, have you ever seen hype? I'm going to have to keep my word to that, you know, fam. So we're going to wrap it up. Observer, thank you so much for taking the time out. It's TV Sound System. Please comment, like, subscribe below, and we'll be back. And hopefully, with our hearts and our minds, we might have another interview with Observer as world champions.
All right.
Enough respect every time.
Yeah, man.
Yes, please.
Respect selector hype every time.